10x advanced tutorial. Now, if you're new to my channel, welcome. I've got a lot of videos on beginner and advanced techniques, as well as stories about being a dancer, so please make sure you check them out. Now, today we are doing an advanced combination. Combinations are a really good thing to know because, especially if you're improvising, it's nice to have lots of things in your tool belt so you can pull them out and keep your dance interesting and dynamic. So, the combination we're learning today is with accents and is like this. Yes, so as you can see, it's quite a simple one, but it's really nice, especially if you're working with a drum solo or any music where you want to hit that beat. So, what are we doing? Firstly, we start with our hips apart, pelvis tucked in, chest up. Always with good posture. I know I'm always going on about keeping your posture strong, but the reason why is because when you're belly dancing, if your posture's not strong and not correct, you can injure yourself. So make sure you remind yourself, always stand up with your pelvis tucked in and your chest up. We're now working through isolations with our hips. So I'm pushing back to the side, in and side. Out, side, in, side. Out, side, in, side. So from this angle you can see, I'm going back to the side, in, to the side. Back. So when you can see this, you can see that when I go back, I'm pushing all my weight back in my hips, but then as I go to the side, I'm moving to one side, not so much with my hips, not stretching out, just like a little flick over. Then as I come back in, my weight is center again. So when it's forward and back, my weight is center. When it's to the side, my weight is slightly to that side. So again, just watch my hips and watch my feet. Out, 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 out. So you can see posture very strong, trying to isolate just the hips. The next part is our down, down. So with the down, down, again, strong posture, and you're dropping the hip. So it's like a hip drop, but your feet are still parallel, still hip width apart. So down, 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 down. From this side, you can see down, 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 down. So you can see it working in my knees, but my feet stay pretty much in the same place. So let's bring those first two moves together. So we've got one, two, three, four, down, down. Again, one, two, three, four, down, down. One more time, one, two, three, four, down, down. The next move is in and out with your pelvis. So you're pulling in, bring these muscles in here, and then out. In, out, in, out. From the side, in, out, in, out, in, out. Now because it's an accented move, when you pull in, it's like you're drawing it in, but you still want to keep it in an accent. So in and then out. In, out. In, out, in, out. So I feel when I'm going in, I'm squeezing through my stomach here, but also through my glutes. And then when I go out, it's almost like a release, but pushing it through and knowing when I'm going to stop so that it's really sharp. So let's bring the whole combination together. One, two, three, four, down, down, in, out. Again, one, two, three, four, down, down, in, out. From the side, one, two, three, four, down, down, in, out. Now what's really nice with this is you can have your hands under your hair, it's really lovely, just keeping them out of the way because you are working quite a lot with your hips, but also it's very important to stay balanced, so you don't want to do too much with your arms because it might be off-putting. The other thing I like to do is doing it up on my toes and having one foot in front. So I'll just show you so you can see the different dynamics of this move. One, two, three, four, down, down, in, out. Again, one, two, three, four, down, down, in, out. And if you want to get really complicated and keep this combination, you can add some layers and dynamics into it. So when I'm here, one, two, three, four, down, down, in, out. One, two, three, four, down, down, in, out. When I'm down on the ground, it's a lot harder to do coming up because the weight and the accents are down. So it's a bit strange to do a down accent as you're coming up. So what I like to do is either a shoulder shimmy to come up, which is really nice, or an undulation. So I'll show you that all together. One, two, three, four, down, down, in, out. One, two, three, four, down, down, in, out, and undulate up. So I hope you like this combination. Please let me know your thoughts. I would love to hear from you. And also, if you have other combinations that you like to do for accented moves, please let me know. I'd really like to see some of your favorites. Thank you very much for watching, and happy dancing.